Hello and welcome. My name is Benjamin Stewart at BenjaminLStewart.net, making teaching and learning more transparent. Today is September 25th, 2022. In episode 109, I'll discuss workflow for teachers who want to get things done. If you have any thoughts, insights, or want to share any of your experiences related to today's topic, feel free to reach out to me at my Twitter handle at BNLEEZ. Today, I want to share with you my current workflow, talking primarily about the following technologies: Google Chrome, the Google Chrome extension Save Pin Tabs, RemNote, Moodle as an LMS or learning management system, and Canva. So sharing my screen, I'll start with showing you Moodle. And the way that I've currently set up Moodle, if I go into Edit Settings, I have chosen to use the course format to show only one section per page. Now, I deal with modules, or each week is a module in Moodle. I have four classes this fall 2022 semester. I have over 100 students that I have that are using Moodle, and I maintain grades, course content, activities, assignments, all within this platform. So I've set up where each week is a module, and one of the Google Chrome extensions that I use most frequently is one called Save Pinned Tabs. So if you are looking here at my screen, I have two types of tabs that I have open, some that are pinned and others that are not pinned. So this extension saves only the pinned tabs. So the way that I have chosen to use this extension is I have saved pin tabs that are associated with each of the four classes that I have this semester. So for example, I have a course called Communicative Abilities in English. If I were to upload or load these tabs, these pinned tabs, you'll notice here that I have three pinned tabs that are currently related to the course that I'm teaching this semester called Communicative Abilities in English. Now, if I were to open up saved pin tabs, or the pin tabs that are related to another course I'm teaching, Assessment of Learning in English, I have many more saved pin tabs that I have currently associated with this course. If I open up another course called Writing One, I have a set of pin tabs that are associated with that particular class. Now, the great thing about this is I have all my courses this semester are face-to-face. So we are fortunate enough to have computers and large screens in each of the classrooms. So the nice feature about this extension is that it syncs across all of the browsers that I happen to use, whether I'm accessing the browser from home, from the office, or from a particular classroom. So all of these pinned tabs that I have set up here, they automatically sync to any location I happen to be opening up the browser. So if I save, or if I, save a particular set of pin tabs here, they will automatically open up when I'm in the classroom in the moment, in front of a group. The browser opens up those saved pin tabs automatically. So it saves a little bit of time getting started each day, as you know, the minutes, seconds count when you're in the moment opening up a browser. And especially if it takes a while to open up for other reasons related to maybe a slower broadband connection, or maybe just an overall slow machine in general, this allows me to get right into the tabs that I need for that particular class. So as I'm planning my classes, right, each week, each day, sometimes I'm updating these pin tabs as it relates to the course that I'm going to teach next. And so again, it just streamlines the process for me in the planning stages, and when I get into the classroom in the moment, getting to what I need to start the class. All right, so you'll notice here that I have modules set up, and each week, each module, I have a label. Now, I use Canva to create labels. I have projects set up in Canva and folders that relate to each of the classes that I'm teaching. And you'll notice here that I have chosen to use a similar design label for all of the classes just to keep it fairly consistent. But this is what I use to generate the labels that I later bring into the Moodle platform for each of the modules, just to offer a visual component, but also usually an essential question that relates to that particular week, or just general information that pertains to the overall goal or objective that we're trying to meet. So this is how I use Canva to bring in some kind of visual element and some essential questions that help us stay focused for that particular week. Now, the last thing I'd like to share here is a note-taking service called RemNote. I've used a lot of different note-taking apps over the years, but RemNote is my note-taking app of choice. And this is what I use to maintain my personal knowledge management system, basically. So anything that I'm researching, that I'm reading, that I'm sharing online, anything that I come across really is organized in RemNote. And that includes my lesson planning. So what I've chosen here to do is pin a couple of, actually four different documents in RemNote that share my lesson planning. Now, you can really get granular in this app if you want to create a template, let's say a lesson plan template or a scope and sequence template that you want to use repeatedly over the course of a semester. I've chosen to simplify my planning stages. I tend not to create a lesson plan per day or per week necessarily, but I do have a general outline that I go through or that I use as I plan my activities day to day. Now, I will get into when I have, for example, some instructions for a particular task, I will build out those instructions in detail, very specifically in RemNote first, and then bring it over to the learning management system as necessary. So there are cases where I create either instructions or just supplementary information that I want to bring into my classroom. I will build it out first in RemNote and then copy and paste it over to Moodle. Now, at the time of this recording, one of the features that I wish that RemNote had was the ability to embed a RemNote into a page or an assignment or just a website in general. For example, using an iframe to bring in and embed a RemNote where I could work more in RemNote and then have that automatically populate throughout, let's say, Moodle, so not to have to copy and paste over information or even link information from Moodle to RemNote. I have tried that throughout the semester so far, and it's been kind of hit or miss. Sometimes students, for whatever reason, are not able to access RemNote using a link from Moodle. And sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. Not really sure yet why that is, but it's something that I do use occasionally, just having a link to ask students to refer to more detail or the instructions by going directly into RemNote. So we'll see how that changes over time, if that gets easier. But I think ideally, again, if there were a way to embed RemNote into Moodle, for example, that would be a great feature that that I would use quite often. So I use RemNote to basically do the legwork, so to speak, first in this space. I do my planning, and it makes it very easy by having some of these pinned documents off to the left that I can easily switch from class to class and put my ideas and thoughts together and planning before I then bring that over to the Moodle website. So currently, these are the tools that I'm using, and I find it very useful. My process has been streamlined quite a bit using the platform Moodle, using RemNote to plan and bring in course content, and especially using the extension Save Pin Tabs in the Google browser so that I can easily navigate from class to class and also from planning outside of class, and once I get into the classroom, being able to automatically sync that those pen tabs into whatever browser I happen to be using, whatever computer I happen to be using, so that I can save a little bit of time getting started day to day with my groups. So I'm curious if you are using any similar types of processes or technologies. Feel free to share if you want to reach out to me on my Twitter handle at BNLEEZ. My name is Benjamin Stewart at BenjaminLStewart.net, making teaching and learning more transparent. Thanks for listening.